Yeah, so as you mentioned, like the faculty is the best voted faculty in Slovakia. Yeah, so minimum you need to be 17 and maximum there is no maximum. So this year I had one client who got accepted to he's over 60.
All right.
Year we as a method we will organize the online preparatory course.
Hello and welcome to MedHead, your medical study guide for studying in Europe, studying in different countries, medical, medicine, dentistry, pharma, and so on. So we have Mr. Peter, who is expert in paperworks, in exchange of students, bringing students to Europe in general for medical studies. Thank you, Mr. Peter, for joining the video.
Thank you very much.
And today we are going to discuss one of the best faculties of medicine in Slovakia, where we are situated in. It's a part of the Communist University, and we are going to discuss details about it. So which faculty are we discussing today about?
So now we will discuss Jessenius Faculty of Medicine, which is located in Martin, and it's part of the Communist University.
That's great. First things first, Mr. Peter, like students need to understand, because medicine in general is quite expensive, and I heard that the Martin faculty is more affordable. So how much does the fees come for students?
So currently the fees are 10,900 euros.
Okay.
After a recent increase of the fees at the Faculty of Medicine in Košice, like this will be the most affordable faculty in Slovakia.
Okay, that's interesting. The other part is what's the study structure? In general, in Slovakia, medical studies are 6 years long. Consist of 360 ECTS European credit transfer, and in general, any details you want to add? What's the degree and so on about the university as well?
Yeah, so as you mentioned, like the faculty is the best voted faculty in Slovakia. It's 6 years course, and they have 150 seats each year. Open for the international students, and the structure of the nationalities that study at the faculty is really interesting.
Okay.
Because I think not only in Slovakia but never in Europe you will find faculty where most of students are from Norway and Iceland.
Really? So there are like a lot of international students, it means?
Definitely, because I think more than half of the university, of the faculty are international students.
Wow.
What was interesting during the COVID pandemic, there were actually hundreds of the Norwegian students, doctors, that offered their help to come to Slovak hospitals to help the patients.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
It's really amazing. It's a great international exposure you're going to get, like with a lot of international students from around the globe, around Europe. So that's amazing. And what about the background of the university? Because generally, you know, when you're like graduating from a faculty university, you need that brand renown. So obviously, you told that it's one of the best in, or the best medical faculty in Slovakia. But what's the background or global ranking of the university?
Mm-hmm. So the Communist University itself, it's among top 800 universities.
Okay.
But as per the subject medicine, it's in top 500 universities, according to the QS ranking.
Wow, that's nice if you're graduating from a faculty which is in top 500 around the globe. And what's the recognition of the degree? Is it recognized only in Europe or also around in the world?
Yeah, so it's recognized both in the EU, that's automatic, or you are eligible then to go for the USMLE in US, or for the similar exam in Canada. So basically, you're eligible to work in almost any country in the world.
Okay, that's interesting. And let's build up a bit of hype about the university itself. So yeah, we spoke about the ranking and everything, but I also heard there's like very strong research, academic things and all this work. Would you like to mention something from that?
Yeah, so there are three centers of excellence and research, plus there is Biomed Research Center, which was constructed recently. So there is like a lot of opportunities for the students to touch research, but also to be in direct touch with the patients. We usually discuss also the monthly costs, like in Martin, when you are definitely you do not need to spend much on the public transport because it's not that big city, but everything is walkable distance, even the university hospital, where the students can go during their clinical years for the training. So everything is very close by, and basically students are very well established in the city.
All right.
And
When you're adding this, I would like also to ask you that what about, for example, like accommodation and these sort of like living expenses in general in Modern?
The faculty provides also dormitories for the international students.
That's great.
The rule is the sooner you come, the bigger chance you have you get accommodation.
Okay.
So they have two accommodations. So one providers, one is Pavla Orsega Vezosla and second is Laca Novomeského. You can get like place in a bed in double or triple room. You can also pay extra in case there is capacity if you want second beds to be empty.
All right.
So the monthly expense will be, it will start from 125 for double room, or single room can be 150 to 200 euros.
That's cool. That's cool. Like, what's the procedure and the timeline to apply? Like when like students are mostly in the final year of high school, they want to apply, they want to finish everything. So what's the timeline in general?
Yes, so the faculty has three dates for the entrance exam.
Okay.
And the deadline for the application is every time approximately 2 weeks before the entrance exam being done. So the absolutely latest deadline is 1st of August to submit the application.
Okay.
So there are only few documents to be submitted. So you need to give pay 70 euros. Then a copy of passport, medical certificate, and a high school diploma with the apostille and official translation to Slovak or English language.
All right. These all services, like mostly with like paperwork and everything, is provided by Mr. Peter. So do contact him. Also with consultation, if you want, like his contact will be in the description, email as well. So do contact him regarding consultation if you want, which university, which faculty is suitable for you, affordability and everything. Like you can discuss with him in details. And Mr. Peter, like, is there any age criteria for students to get in?
Yeah, so minimum you need to be 17 and maximum there is no maximum. So this year I had one client who got accepted to he's over 60 if I'm not mistaken.
So wow, and he wants to study medicine?
John, if you watch this, hello.
It's, wow.
Yeah, he studies because basically he was paramedic in New York.
Okay.
And he decided he wants to switch in his career. I suppose it was his whole life dream to become student.
Wow.
And he has family in Slovakia.
Okay.
So that's how we got in touch and that's how he decided to be. Martin is in central Slovakia, so that's how he got decided for this faculty.
That's really interesting and quite motivating, like starting back your studies at 60. Wow.
Yeah.
That's interesting, like pursuing your dreams at 60, why not? That's really motivating and a bold decision for sure.
Well,
for John.
Yeah, like they're saying that why you should now spend 6 years with studies, like you don't know what will happen in 6 years, but basically you will in 6 years still you will be just 6 years older. So you will be 6 years older plus you will be doctor. So
yeah that's true. And like for medicine it's never late because like doctors practice until like, you know, like almost the end, so they can practice for a long time. So it's never too late to study, especially medicine.
Mm.
And anyway, it's never late to complete your education or go for higher education. There's nothing bad in doing that. But Mr. Peter, like when you spoke about the exam, so what's the exam structure? What should students expect?
Yeah, so there, the exam is fully online. You need to have 360 degree camera.
Okay.
You will get
a
link. Well, or basically,
you need to show the room.
You need to show room. So what you can do also, you will get a mirror and you will just show like no one is in the room because basically you cannot exit or no one can enter the room.
Okay.
You you just show your ID at the beginning and then everything is recorded and you get a link to test the environment 3 days before the exam.
Okay.
And it's then you get the result. So basically it's 80 questions Biology, totally 40 are biology, 40 are chemistry. You cannot get like booklet with the questions, so basically everyone sees the question first time on the exam.
Oh, all right.
And approximately you need to get 32, 33 points out of 80.
Okay.
Each question has just one correct answer, so you cannot score more than 80. So minimum is like...
And you mentioned, I think there are like 150 seats, something like that.
150 seats.
Okay. So and chances are like still good, like to get in the university. But anyway, like it's competitive as well. So generally, like, is there any preparatory courses? Because like when we were discussing about communist universities, like Arska Fakulta in Bratislava, they had like some preparatory courses to prepare for the exam and so on. So is there any preparatory courses here?
I do not know information about the faculty, but this year we, as a method, we will organize the online preparatory course with the experienced teachers who do the same for the SLOI program. And this year we will also include the English preparation for the classes.
Okay.
So totally you can get up to 50 hours of the tuition for the biology.
All right.
And 50 hours of chemistry. Also, you will be under supervision of the experienced teacher. So in case you have any question, you need to you have like some contact point which can give you explanation.
And how long is the course duration going to be?
It will be like it will be like self-paced course. So it will be according to you, because someone decided very last minute to come for the medicine. So if you can do it in 2 weeks, you can do it in 4 weeks, it's up to you. So if you are interested, make sure to contact us and you will get more information about
this. For sure. Like, do contact us regarding like medical preparation, because it's quite important that your biology chemistry especially is like well prepared for the entrance exams. And more or less in every university in Europe, you need some sort of like entrance examination in order to like get in. So it's better you prepare it beforehand.
Yeah.
But in general, Mr. Peter, like, there are also like several transfer students, you know, who are not like studying for the first time or straight out of high school. Mm-hmm. So what's the scenario with like transfer students? Are they accepted in the university in the first place? And the second thing is like, do they have to give the entrance exam?
Well, theoretically, they can also come without the entrance exam,
okay,
but only if they are still student and all marks are A to C and they do not have any backlogs.
Okay.
They can apply for the direct transfer, but so far all the students which I helped, they firstly passed the entrance exam. Again, like there is the same rule that you can have maximum mark C. Of maximum 7 years old can be the subjects.
Okay, so until 7 years subjects from 7 years past, you can be recognized. It cannot be like more than 7 years.
Exactly, and theoretically, even you can go to fifth year.
I had
two students from UK who got to fifth year. They study before at Ukraine.
Okay, that's interesting. Because many universities after the Ukrainian, Ukraine-Russia conflict started, started their studies in other universities and wanted the recognition and transfer in other countries. And many universities didn't provide this or just asked them to start from the first year. Mm-hmm. Whereas Slovak universities are like accepting them, recognizing their studies, study programs, and also like subjects. So this is very interesting. And the other thing is like if you're a recognized degree up to 5 years, so it means like you're really in the high level and you can complete the degree in one more year. So that's super useful actually. But yeah, it's something to be very careful about, because in general, like medical studies are 6 years long and your subjects are recognized for 7 years. It means like it might be the case that, for example, your first year subjects might not be recognized because of the time frame. Mm-hmm. If you're coming like from fifth year or sixth year or something like this. So that's why you need to be like really careful and evaluate your profile. So for that, like we have Mr. Peter who provides consultation, provides all the paperwork, guidance that you might require to contact him. His contact will be in the link in the description. And Mr. Peter, like thanks for all this information. Like I hope our viewers found it useful. Please like the video if you enjoyed watching it, found it useful. Share it with someone who's planning to study medicine. Thanks a lot for watching again. Until next time, the Jessenius.
Bye bye.